Hi everyone, we're here today with Karin Rousset, the founder of Sweet Zurich Tours and the blogger of My Kugelhopf. Welcome. Hello. Can you tell us a bit more about yourself and what led you to Switzerland?
Sure. I'm originally from New York, but I've been living in Switzerland for almost 5 years now, actually. And my passions are very simply food and travel. And when I say food, that's pretty much 99.9% sweet, so dessert, chocolates, all that, all the good stuff. And since I've been in Switzerland, I've really been kind of using my work and play all kind of as one. Writing and traveling and blogging and doing the tours, as we'll talk about later. But what brought me there was very unoriginal. It was my husband's work, more on the finance side of things. So it was very lucky, though, because we moved there. I'd never been at all and just fell in love with it. So it worked out very, very well.
And how did the Sweet Zurich Tour start?
They started very naturally, actually. I'd kind of been doing the tours already for a few years even before they were official, because I'd have friends and family that would come visit. And what would we do? Of course, I would take them to Splungli, the famous chocolate name, but I'd also want to take them to my little favorite shops that maybe weren't as well known, the places that I'd been going for 2 or so years, and the people became very good friends, the shop owners. So we'd go, we'd taste, of course, I'd tell them all about the people and the shop, and it was kind of a tour in the making. And then I would also get a lot of emails and questions through my site or through various social media, you know, where do you go for the best this pastry or that dessert, or where should I go for this kind of chocolate? So I realized that there was, you know, this kind of market that I could really share all this information, not just on my blog, but as I'm a people person, obviously, I love to share it with people.
But is there anything you miss about living in New York?
Miss about New York? Other than my family and friends, of course, I would say New York energy. There's definitely an energy to the city that's very unique, and also 24/7, that energy. You know, it's that is a big, big difference when you go to Zurich. Things are not accessible all around the clock. But yeah, I think this energy of the people that you really feel just walking around, walking on the streets, and you can exchange with these people. That's another thing I miss, being a people person. I love to just chit-chat, and you can do that wherever you are at any time. But just on the corner, you know, the red light, people may talk to you, or at a store, that kind of thing. It's very kind of just open and friendly, and I miss that, I would say. That's one thing.
And what advice would you give to Americans visiting Zurich for the first time, like things to do?
Things to do. Well, it depends, summer or winter, because as you'll see, the city is very, very different.
Let's pick summer.
The summer, go to the lake. If the sun is shining, you hope, the whole city is down by the lake, and there's an amazing atmosphere. People are on pedal boats or different boats and hanging out, picnicking, just happy that, you know, it's not gray and raining and outside, and there's just a really great vibe to the city. You know, there is also great energy to Zurich, as I was saying about New York, but it's very different. But because sometimes winter can be long and gray, once the summer comes, you want to be outside and hiking or biking and walking and swimming in the lakes and just taking advantage of all that is really there to enjoy. And that's also why I love Switzerland. There's so much stuff all the time.
Well, thanks very much for meeting with us today. We wish you all the best.
Thanks.